and welcome to my channel. Today we're here to talk about An American Marriage by Tayari Jones. This was a 2018 Oprah Book Club selection, so you know there was so much hype. This came out this year. It is a fiction novel, and there's just been so much talk about it. I wanted to give this a read, but as you guys know, I always put things on hold at the library, and the holds for this were real. So it took me a little bit of a minute to get my hands on it. But when I did, I finished this in 2 days. I could not put this down. Before I give away too much, I will let you guys know already, I gave this 3 stars on Goodreads, and I will explain why I gave it 3 stars. I think it's a good book. There were some aspects that I loved about it, and then some aspects that just, it didn't wow me, but it was still a solid and really good read. So the story is about a young couple who are newlyweds. So we're getting to know their relationship through these letters that they are writing one another. And I thought that was just so beautiful, like to have it written in the form of love letters, essentially at first, to really get you to understand their relationship and basically how everything kind of transpired to where they are now. So it's basically a young couple. They've been married 1.5 years, and they are going back to Roy, which is her husband, his hometown, which is a small town in Louisiana, and tragedy hits where he is, you know, wrongly accused and incarcerated for a crime that he did not commit. So they're newlyweds. You're going on this journey with them. His wife's name is Celestial. And oops, is that? Yeah, I always want to call her Celeste. I had to really check. His wife's name is Celestial, and you know, they're pretty much figuring out how they're going to make this marriage work with him getting a pretty hefty sentence and them not have been married that long, and what type of toll it's going to take. But with this, we also get to learn the relationship that she has with one of her really, really good friends that she grew up with as a child, Andre, who is actually also friends with her husband. They were college friends. And you know, the relationship dynamics of that, as well as the relationship dynamics of their parents. So we get to find out about Celestial's parents and the trials that that marriage had to go through. And then we also find out about Roy, his father, Big Roy, and his mother, Olive, and their relationship. And I just thought it was so beautiful to show that, you know, every marriage has their own unique struggles, but you know, some situations are really well beyond your control, and it's just such an unfortunate take. I could not put this book down. This was literally a book, like, once I picked it up, it was like, I need to know how this resolved. And reading the letters, I thought it was really crazy at how you could tell, like, the emotions and the feelings change as, you know, the years went by, and it's like you're becoming more and more distant. Like, you could feel the distance growing between them through the correspondence, which I, for whatever reason, that warped me. Like, for me, when I started the book and I was reading it, I was like, I love this book. Like, this is crazy and amazing. I think once we got out of the letters, I was still warped and so into it, but it made me focus more on the story and maybe more so focus on what is going to be the end result of this marriage. I will say that I felt like, if you haven't watched the book, it really felt kind of like I could see this being a movie. I could actually see this playing out on screen. I would say that if you haven't read the book, and this isn't going to be big spoilers, but if you don't want any details and you want to go in completely blind, just know that I think this is a solid, really good book to give a go at, but I'm gonna get a little bit more in depth for those of you who have read it, because I want to talk about this one. This is one I just really want to talk about. So I was just like, okay, so I watched, I think it's the Good Morning America clip, Tayari Jones and Oprah and everybody talking about the book, and I love that the author was like, this was actually sparked by a conversation and a real life couple that she overheard happening at Lenox Mall in Atlanta. And I, you know, I used to live in Atlanta, so I was like, I don't know, I just really liked hearing the story and hearing what inspired this book. And She was like, basically someone was like, the lady, she was really nicely put together and looked really, really good. And she was with the guy who looked kind of like, his shoes were scuffed. He looked a little like, you know, life was a little harder for him. And she was like, Rory, do you think that you would have waited 7 years for me? And he was like, this wouldn't even have happened to you. And that's like actually in the book, which I think is so dope. I've read the book before I saw that, but I was like, oh my gosh, like this was a real like conversation she overheard, which made the story that much cooler for me. But getting into their marriage, it's interesting. I know no relationship is perfect, but I was like, before he even went to prison, I felt like this wasn't a relationship that could withstand hardly anything. Like, it was already not withstanding anything. There was infidelity, and for me, like, whenever I hear the infidelity, like, for me, that's just like a no. this isn't good. Warning signs, and the fact that he was so comfortable, like, when he was talking about how, you know, but she knew I loved her. And, you know, he made it sound like the cheating wasn't that bad. He just liked having sex with other people and liked the attention. Or like whatever relations he had with other females. And I'm like, this is insane. And this is not a healthy marriage or a healthy relationship. So it's just interesting to see, because part of me, I was so upset at Roy at times, but then there were some times where I found myself upset at Celestial and like just her indifference and her kind of like, you know, well, life happens. I felt like regardless, you don't stop visiting your husband, but then do you or do you not? I think that's the good part about this book, because kind of like the author said, there is no right or wrong. You know, everybody goes about relationships in their own way. And in this book, it did a really good job of not making anybody completely blameless and not making anybody completely like at fault at the same time. And that's kind of how marriage is. Like, there's always two sides to a conflict, or there's two sides to a story, two sides to how someone feels. It doesn't necessarily mean like sometimes the actions that happen within marriage are so black and white where one person is really at fault, even if two parties end up getting hurt by this inaction, you know? It's just hard. Like, it's really, really hard. For that reason, this book alone, I think, is a good read, because it's a realistic depiction, I think, of what could possibly take place given these circumstances. And I also love that she showed marriages that were faced with crazy obstacles, but yet they were able to either overcome them or sometimes succumb to them and were not able to persevere through it. And also showing that not all marriages begin in this amazing way. For like there is an instance where, how is it when someone you love already has a child and you're raising that child as your own? And also it goes into basically like, how is it when you start off a relationship with infidelity? And like, you know, just different relationship struggles. It also even touches on Andre's parents, which to me, I don't even really, yeah, that's anyways, let's not even get there. Anyways, so I feel like it does a really good job of giving you different examples of marriages. All that being said, I mean, from the jump, I was turned off by Roy. But throughout the book, he has redeeming qualities that help redeem him. But I was just like, Celestial, why did you even marry a guy like this? Like, even before the incarceration, he was cheating on her. He seemed to not think of it as a big deal. His tone about it almost made it seem like, you know, she didn't worry about it either, because she knew that I loved her. I just like attention from other. I was like, ugh, disgusted. Yeah, I thought this was interesting that their marriage even made it to a year and a half, to tell you the truth. So them facing this type of long-term sentence, I was like, I don't know how this is going to work. Part of me, because I believe in marriage, I really was rooting for them to be together and to end up together. But at the same time, I'm like, Lord, why did y'all get married? I wish y'all just never got married, because y'all aren't right for each other. It's kind of how I felt. Like, he also just seemed like he was more of a traditional, like, saw woman, like, kind of like he makes the decisions and he acts like he gave her freedom, but it's not her freedom. It's not freedom you can grant to her. She's a free woman. And because she was such a free spirit and seemed so, like kind of like she kind of had a mind of her own. I'm just shocked that they ended up together. It's kind of what I was thinking while I was reading this. Like, they don't seem like they had that much in common going for each other. Maybe they just inspired each other at that moment. But the fact that they ended up married was something I was harping on, which also is why I kind of wish that it was more so about a book where I felt the two characters, this was a sincere marriage, that these people were probably perfect for each other, but they were faced with such a atrocity early on. Let's see how this unfolds. All that being said, I thought that the book did a really good job of tying out the pieces and getting you to form your own opinions and form your own thoughts. I feel like people who read this book, there's a number of different ways that you could feel about the characters as well as feel about the situation at hand and how it played out. I don't really think that everybody who reads this is going to have the same emotions or the same feelings while reading it. So I greatly appreciated that. Part of me hurt so much for Roy, where I kind of wanted to know what he ended up getting out of the marriage. Like, at the end of the day, when he came back, like, what was he able to walk away with? I know it's not about monetary stuff and stuff of that nature, but I feel like he really lost his life. And, you know, there was a line where I think Dre was saying, like, you know, who, you know, this is unfortunate, but who's got to pay for this? Like, do we have to pay for this? Even though I think, Dre, you're kind of a little trife. I know you love this girl since day one, but bruh, really? I don't know. But at the same time, even though he's a little trife, is he really that trife? Because he did love her since day one. That's what this book does to you. Like, it really makes you feel like there's no right or wrong. So anyways, what were your thoughts if you read this book? All in all, I gave this 3 stars, like I said, on Goodreads. I am very curious to hear what you gave it. So please let me know if you love this book. And hopefully, if you haven't read this book, you were aware that I said that I would be spoiling some details. Anyways, I'll see you guys in my next one. Love and light. Deuces.